Blessed be the one, holy, and living God.
Glory to God forever and ever.
There is one body and one spirit.
There is one hope in God's call to us.
One Lord, one faith, one baptism.
One God, creator of all.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. O God, of unchangeable power and eternal life, look favorably upon your whole church, that wonderful and sacred district. By the effectual working of your providence, carry out with tranquility the plan of salvation. Let the whole world see and know that things which were cast down are being raised up, and things which had grown old are being made new, and that all things are being brought to their perfection by Him through whom all things were made, your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Good afternoon. We're gathered on this beautiful October Saturday afternoon to recognize and give thanks to good, holy, and blessed things that have been unfolding the life and ministry here at St. Barnabas, in our own Diocese of Delaware, in the life and ministry of our Lord, who has accepted the call to come and serve together with us in this new ministry. Today I bring greetings, commendation, and prayers from my friend and colleague Steve Lane, Bishop Lane, who commends Martha this diocese. We are blessed that there are representatives from St. Margaret's, where Martha serves, who are here with us in the congregation this afternoon. We're also joined by the three priests who have served with distinction over these last years. Peter Huner, Humphrey, and Ted Peters. He's bringing distinctive gifts and good spirit to this ministry. We are blessed by all of those who have labored patiently, fervently, and with deep commitment to Christ in the leadership of this parish and of its many ministries. Staff of the parish, wardens, the leaders of the many committees and ministries which make up this church, and especially all those who have been vestry members, wardens, officers of the parish, members of the transition committee, who have done the work of serving us here. We're also grateful to our diocesan climate officer, Gary Rowe, and to members of our standing committee, consultants that have worked so faithfully to create over these months in this shared partnership that's at the heart of this work and serving. Thank you, all of you, for all you have done to bring us to this good, happy day as we look now toward the beauty which is already beginning. People of St. Barnabas, you have reflected on your ministry and discerned your choice for a new rector. Please join us. being protected. Presbyter of the Church of God, you have been called to work together with your bishop, fellow presbyters, as a pastor, priest, and teacher. Take your share in councils of the Church. Now, in accordance with the canons, you have been selected to serve God as rector of St. Bartholomew's Episcopal Church in the Diocese of Delaware. This letter is a sign that you are fully empowered and authorized to exercise this ministry, accepting its privileges and responsibilities in communion with your bishop. Having committed yourself to this work, do not forget the trust of those who have chosen you. Care alike for young and old, strong and weak, rich, by your work and in your life, proclaim the gospel. Love and serve Christ's people. Nourish them and strengthen them to glorify God in this life and in the life of God. May the Lord, who has given you the will to do these things, give you grace and power. Are you, people of St. Mark's, ready to continue your ministry with Mark as your priest?
We are.
I'm going to play your gospel in the world. harvest, you send out laborers into this harvest. Go on your way. See, I am sending you out like lambs into the midst of wolves. Carry no purse, no bag, no sandals, and greet no one on the road. Whatever house you enter first, say, peace to this house. And if anyone is there who shares in peace, your peace will rest on that person. If not, it will return to you. Remain in the same house, eating and drinking whatever they provide, for the laborer deserves to be paid. Do not move about from house to house. Whatever you enter a town, and its people welcome you, eat what is set before you. Cure the sick or lame, and say to them, the kingdom of God has come near to you. Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
Had begun her life as a seminarian. Harvard Divinity School, and that meant going back and forth between Maine and Cambridge, Massachusetts, and it must have been the fall, because she was not around. It must have been term time when I began worshiping at St. Andrew's. And at the time, though a lifelong Episcopalian, I found myself really in the grip of an intense curiosity and wonder about God, something that ultimately would turn out to be my own beginnings of my own exploration as a call to ordained ministry. In the face of all of that intensity, nearly everyone at St. Andrew's, including and maybe even especially the clergy, said to me, "Oh, you need to meet Martha Kirkpatrick." So there we would be, so Sunday after Sunday, at the coffee hour, I'd be chatting with people and telling people my thoughts, and they would say, "Lara, there, dear, you need to meet Martha Kirkpatrick. You need to meet Martha Kirkpatrick." And they were right. Martha did not just tolerate my enthusiasm, but I learned, came to share it. And that led ultimately to virtually dozens over the years of long, wonderful, warm evenings of great food, sometimes fancy, sometimes plain, but always of terrific, terrific conversation, where we talk about everything under the sun, including the geeky things I really loved. And I know her, therefore, as a generous colleague and as a person committed to shared ministry, even before we had ordained ministries to share. And that's why I'm not so surprised that she has chosen the lections she has for this day. Look at what Jesus advises in our gospel reading. First, go in pairs. This mission of sharing in the good news about the kingdom of God is not a solitary one. As I know you know this, right? That's why you went through that long and deliberate process of calling a rector. You need a partner to go out into the world. You need someone to go into the community with you. And so does Martha. It's worth noting, I suppose, that Jesus does not give a lot of specifics about what those 70 were supposed to do or say. They were just supposed to go and be in relationship with one another and with the community in Jesus' name, and then see what happens. So Martha hasn't come here. I know you actually probably know this. Martha has not come here to bring you God, to fix your problems, or do ministry for you. She's come to partner with you. She's come here to put her feet in step with yours, going out with you to share in the discovery of what God is already doing in this particular neck of the woods, joining you in colluding with God in ministry, and both of you being changed as a result. The next instruction Jesus gives is to take nothing with you. Be light on those feet that carry you into mission. And I suppose this is kind of a difficult instruction for me. I don't know about you, but I rarely leave the house without a bag. And in the bag is, you know, a bottle of water, and my thing with tea, and a book just in case I get stuck someplace, and one of those smartphones that you can sort of have the entire world's worth of information at the press of a button. But Jesus' instructions are to take nothing with you. And I suppose that's one way of saying, leave your baggage behind. Things that did not work in the past, things that worked this way in a different era, even sometimes the things that work in the church down the street, all of those things, carrying those, will cause you to be distracted. So leave them behind. Jesus calls us to go out in mission to our communities and be fully present with those who are there in the here and now, not weighed down by distractions or expectations. So I urge you to use this time as you're getting to know your new mentor, to have a fresh start and listen to one another about where and how you might go forward from here. And then, important advice, Jesus reminds the 70 that this is not an easy assignment. He sends them out as sheep among wolves. So sometimes your life and ministry together will be great. You'll encounter hospitality, and there'll be wonderful encounters with God through one another. You'll feel the Spirit moving. Or as St. Paul puts it in that beautiful letter to the Philippians, you'll know that God is at work in you, enabling you both to will and to work for his good pleasure. Other times, though, won't be so great. Sometimes you'll go out into the community and be rejected. Sometimes you'll try something new and it just won't work. You will discover your weak spots. And hopefully this won't be news to you, but at some point your director will make a mistake. And at some point, you will make one too. That's okay. Shake the dust from your feet. Not in protest, but in confidence that you can go on, knowing that God is always with you. God was continuing to walk among you as you prepared for this new rector. God was walking with Martha on her long journey to reach you here. And God is with you now, already waiting for you in the places to which you'll be sent. So, people of St. Barnabas and Martha, go forth boldly in this new and exciting partnership together, confidently declaring that the kingdom of God has come here. And may you return like the 70, full of rejoicing at the sheer wonder of the God we share. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you.
In holy baptism, we receive full adoption through God's grace and full empowerment for ministry through the Holy Spirit. Will you work together as partners in the mission of the Church to reconcile all people to God through Christ?
We will, with God's help.
The water of baptism signifies our eternal covenant with God. In it, we are buried with Christ in his death. By it, we share in his resurrection. Through it, we are reborn by the Holy Spirit. Therefore, in joyful obedience to Christ, we bring into his fellowship those who come to him in faith, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. We pray you, O God, sanctify this water by the power of your Holy Spirit, that all who in baptism are cleansed from sin and born again may continue forever in the risen life of Jesus Christ, our Savior.
Let us renew the solemn promises and vows of holy baptism, by which we renounce Satan and all his works, and promise to serve God faithfully in God's holy Catholic Church. Do you reaffirm your renunciation of evil and renew your commitment to Jesus Christ?
I do.
Do you believe in God the Father?
I believe in God the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, the Son of God?
I believe in Jesus Christ, the Holy Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead.
Do you believe in God, the Holy Spirit?
I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
Will you continue in the Apostles' teaching and fellowship, in the breaking of bread, and in the prayers?
I will, with God's help.
Will you persevere in resisting evil, and whenever you fall into sin, repent and return to the Lord?
I will, with God's help.
Will you proclaim by word and example the good news of God in Christ?
I will, with God's help.
Will you seek and serve Christ in all persons, loving your neighbor as yourself?
I will, with God's help.
Will you strive for justice and peace among all people and respect the dignity of every human being?
I will, with God's help.
May Almighty God, who has given us a new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, bestowed upon us by the forgiveness of sins, and called us to ministry in Jesus Christ, keep us in eternal life by his grace, through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you.
Jesus Christ is always with you.
And also with you.
Thank you.
and we bless you, holy and gracious God, source of life abundant. From before time you made ready, your spirit moved over the deep and brought all things into being. Sun, moon, and stars, earth, wind, and waters, and every living thing. You made us in your image and taught us to walk in your way. But we rebelled against you and wandered far away. And yet, as a mother cares for her children, you would not forget us. Time and again you called us to live in the fullness of your love. And so this day we join with saints and angels in the chorus of praise that brings to eternity, lifting our voices to magnify you as we sing.
Of the earth of the
God.
We give you thanks for restoring us in your image and nourishing us with spiritual food in the sacrament of Christ's body and blood. Now send us forth the people to yield to you, that we may proclaim the love of the world and continue in the risen life of Christ our Savior. Amen.
We have celebrated this new pastoral relationship with a great prayer in turn. Martha, I commend to your love and care the people of St. Barnabas. My brothers and sisters, I commend to your love and care your director, colleague, and friend, Martha. And now, Martha, I ask you to give us a blessing.
God, praise every step of the way. Praise the business of the day. Praise to the heaven of the world is to make us now for any of us. Most of all, for any of us, my Father. Blessed be the one holy and otherwise.